नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। पराभक्तं पुरीशं मयं पुच्छामि गोतमं भगवन्तं पुट्ठुमागम किं परा भवतो मुखं ती। Most Venerable Chief Bante at the Ottawa Buddhist Vihara, our devotees, dear friends in Dhamma, our dear Dhamma school students and parents, I am so pleased that you have all gathered to listen to another Dhamma sermon in English this evening. I plan to explain the sermon in Sinhala at the end. Today, I have been invited by our Dhamma school student, Sanyas family, to give a sermon about negative qualities that could lead a person to their downfall. What are the negative qualities one must avoid in life? And what are the consequences if we don't avoid them? I have chosen the Parabhava Sutta to explain what these negative qualities are. But before we discuss that sutta, Parabhava Sutta, we must first look at the Mangala Sutta. It doesn't do justice to talk about Parabhava Sutta without first talking about the Mangala Sutta. The reason why we must first briefly review the Mangala Sutta is because Mangala Sutta provides us to framework of great qualities we must cultivate in order to live a stress-free, worry-free, depression-free, successful and happy life. Such a path will eventually lead to Nibbana. It is essentially a roadmap to Nibbana. Mangala Sutta advises us on how to attain happiness every moment of our lives. If we cannot find happiness in ourselves in the present moment, how can we expect to attain Nibbana at a future date? Nibbana, on the other hand, is not simply some status we attain supernaturally. It is a state that we must attain through the precise, deliberate and wise choices that we make throughout our life. It must be cultivated over time. The time it takes for each individual will undoubtedly vary, but with determination. It is something that any disciplined person could attain. In summary, Mangala Sutta compels us to look at our own minds to recognize good qualities and poor qualities in ourselves. It looks at the two sides of mind. Additionally, it advises us to honor those who deserve our respect. We must honor and care for our parents and elders. We must only associate with and seek advice from the wise. Those who follow and heed this advice methodically will not only live a worry-free, stress-free, and a happy life, but they have the potential to achieve Nibbana at the end. In this lifetime itself, can enter what is known as Kshema Bhumi. Kshema Bhumi, that is a Sanskrit word. Pali word is Kshema Bhumi, which means liberation, realm in English. Liberation realm in English. Now we will move on the Parabhava Sutta. Parabhava Sutta is an addendum or a supplementary to the Mangala Sutta. However, unlike the Mangala Sutta, the Parabhava Sutta focuses on the consequences of leading a negative or unwholesome life and making unwise choices. Later on in the sermon, we will look closely at these negative qualities. First, let's look at the circumstances that led to Buddha having to provide this advice. One night, when the Buddha was staying at the Anathapindika Arama's temple, Anathapindika Arama in the Jetagro in Sravasti in India, a deity came to visit him. According to the legend, the entire Jetagro was illuminated by the deity's radiance. With honor and utmost respect to the Buddha, the deity required about the qualities that lead to the downfall of human being. This is the meaning that I recited at the beginning of the Dhammadesana as a topic. The Buddha answered by stating that it is, in fact, very easy to tell who will succeed in life and who will not. Those who follow the virtuous activities will succeed, and those who make unwholesome choices will surely fail in life. The deity then asks for more precise information or examples of what these negative qualities are and how it creates negative outcomes. It is important to remember that the advice Buddha provides is not limited to Buddhist. You should remember that. The advice is suitable for any human beings, regardless of religion, race, ethnic background, and whether they are young or old. The Buddha explains how the mind is the forerunner, how the mind is the forerunner in all that we do. The mind is the center in all our activities. I suppose you know that. Before we go any further, I want to take the time to talk about our mind and the effect of our mind on our actions. Let's frame this in the context of the very famous book Dhammapada that I shared this gatha, this stanza, with the, you during Dhamma school about a week ago. I think Sanya remember that. It goes something like this.
Manupubbhangama dhamma manusittha manumaya manasati pasannina bhasati va karoti va tatunam sukhamam veti chayav anapaini.
Which means the mind is the forerunner of all good states. Mind is the chief. Mind made Adi. If one speaks or acts with a pure mind, happiness follows one as naturally as one's own shadow that never leaves. The Buddha explains that the mind is the forerunner behind all our activities. When your mind engages with good qualities, think about what kind of person you will become. What kind of person you will become. What type of thoughts will you have? What type of activities will you engage in? There will be a gradual change in you to become a person with high moral values, who focuses on spiritual growth and evolution. The good will follow you. Happiness follow you as naturally as the shadow that follows you all your life. Then you can ask the question, what happened to about the when we follow the bad activities? What happens if you choose the wrong path? You can ask the same question.
Manopubbhangama dhamma manositta manomaya manasati padutena bhasati va karoti va tatonam dukkhamam veti chakkam vahatu padam.
Now you see, mind is the forerunner of all evil states. Mind is the chief. Mind made Adi. If one speaks or acts with a wicked mind, a previous stanza mentioned mind with the pure mind. Here mentioned speaks or acts with a wicked mind. Suffering follows one as naturally as the wheel that follows the hoof of an ox. In the Ampada explain like that. I am sure you have seen in your lives example of those who have made unwise choices. I am sure you could think of someone that you know who may be leading in such a path. I want to share with you how the Buddha explained this. What was this advice to you through his answer to the deity? Right now, let's focus on your mind and your thoughts, not others. Okay? We tend to see other people's flaws first. That is our natural process. Most of people, not everybody. We rarely look into ourselves. This sermon is not for the person who is sitting beside you or other people who are close to you. This is only for you, for your benefit. When you look into your own mind, you have to notice that your mind is the leader that makes you want to do things. It directs you to do things. So when you do something wrong, you have to accept that it was done starting with thoughts that occurred in your own mind. The first reason is you, not others. It is started in your mind. Then you make choices. The Buddha explained that you cannot blame other spiritual beings or other around you, your friends or foes, for your mistakes. From an early age, you have to train your mind to accept responsibility for your own actions. You are the director of your own movie of life. Am I right when I say that? You are the director of your own movie of your life. The director chooses all aspects of the movie. Same way, you must direct the movie of your life in the right path or good direction. How do we do this? A clear guide is the you heard this before when I preach in the Mangala Sutta. A clear guide is the Dasa Kusa. We follow the 10 wholesome activities. What are the? Abstain from destroying life. All beings value their lives. Second one, abstain from taking what is not given, stealing. Third one, abstain from wrong conduct in regard to sense pleasures. Fourth one is abstain from false speech. Next is abstain from slanderous speech. Abstain from harsh speech. Number seven is abstain from idle chatter. Eight is abstain from covetousness. Number nine is abstain from ill will, wanting to see others fail. Last one, number 10 is abstain from the wrong view. Conversely, you should develop the right view. As children, when you are thinking about your future, not only children, adults also can think. Plan in what you want to do next few years or next 2-3 decades, or then everybody can see like that. Plan in what you want to do. You need to absorb these qualities. You have to generate these qualities. We cannot expect successful development of a person without good qualities. It should be part of the natural thinking process. In Buddhism, it is called Chitta Niyama. When you learn about the meditation, you will hear this word, Chitta Niyama, which means naturally occurring mental conditions. Teachers cannot force you to do things. Your parents cannot force you to do things. They will try to lead you to the right path. They will force. But you have to choose. It should be part of your natural thinking process. Conversely, if you manifest negative thoughts, negative qualities, you will have negative results regardless of your religion or belief system. This is a natural, universal truth, absolute truth. In the third stanza, in Parabhava Sutta, the Buddha talks about other qualities or characteristics of those who are on a path of self-destruction. Those who like to sleep all the time. those who are lazy, lethargic, always tired. Surely everyone needs at least 8 hours of restful sleep at night. That is sure. That helps repair our bodies and enhance our mental concomitants. We are talking about people who sleep well into the day or at unusual times. Another characteristic of someone who is on a negative path is those who constantly come up with excuse not to do things, constantly delays things. There is no motivation to succeed. They wait to receive things from others, help from friends to do homework or some other works, wanting money from parents. Basically, waiting for things to come to them. One of their favorite phrases is, what is the favorite phrases is? Everybody know, let's do it tomorrow. Yes, always postpone. That's the habit. Let's do it tomorrow. What we can do today? Ajjeva kichchan aatappa. What we can do today? We must do today. What is the point of delaying things? They are constantly coming up with ways to avoid responsibility, and by doing so, they are wasting valuable time. Time is something that you cannot ever take back. You know that. Once it is gone, it is gone. But we know time is gold. You will never have time back. None of your wealth, connection or prayers will bring time back. Cannot. That is why those who are wise spend their time wisely. They plan their activities and they carry them out on time. Once you do that, you can imagine that success will follow you like the shadow that follows you all your life. Can you think of scenarios where people in your life who are constantly delaying things? Are they successful people? Then can you think of some successful people you know? What are they like? Do they always do things on time? Now, what type of person do you want to be? You can ask yourself this. When you decide what type of person you want to be, planning your future, you must think of the virtuous characteristics that the Buddha mentions in the Mangala Sutta, and you have to consider about Parabhava Sutta, what the Buddha mentioned here. Associating with the wise, for example, will be a foundation in this journey. The Buddha, or you can say Kalyana Mitta, in Sansara Jani, how important those people. The Buddha also mentioned, this is in the third stanza of Parabhava Sutta, he advises the deity that one must choose friends wisely and carefully. Association with the wise people. There is formative parable that we use in teaching about the consequences of whom you should associate with. That is the story of the two parrots. This is very popular story in the Buddhist world among the even children and parents. Two parrots from the same nest that get blown away in a windstorm. One of the parrots landed at the cave of Gang of Thieves. The other parrot landed near a cave of monks. Both parrots get adopted by the people who occupied the caves. Over time, the parrots learned the language of their adopters and the behavior of their adopters. One day, when the king was hunting in the area, gets separated from his entourage, security team, he first ends up near the cave of the thieves. Upon seeing the king dressed in his royal attire, the parrot calls on the thieves to steal royal jewels and clothing from the king. The parrot also yells instructions as to how they should steal. They should beat him up, tie him up, and knock him unconscious before stealing, and then they should kill him. The king, having been separated from his group, becomes very frightened, and runs away as quickly as he could. When he heard amazing speech from the parrots. On this way, the king sees another cave and stops there to catch his breath. Another parrot began to speak. Then another parrot began to speaks to him in a kind and serene way. He says, "Welcome, Your Majesty. So glad you come. Glad you could come. Stay with us for a while. Would you like to have something to drink, etc.?" He began to talk nicely, pleasantly. The king was very surprised. He actually stayed there until his entourage, his security, until found him. About the same time, the monks who occupied the cave arrived. The curious king explained to the monks what had happened in his interaction with the two parrots. The monks then explained to the king that the company you keep or those whom you associate with have a lot to do with whom you become. If you associate with the wise, you too will become wise and successful in life. Conversely, if you associate with the unwise, you will become unsuccessful, unwise, and unhappy person. So, the moral of the story is that even though both parrots came from the same mother and father, the environment in which they grew up in changed their behavior. It is the old argument about nature versus nurture. Nurture is your DNA composition. Nurture is how you are raised, the environment you live in, and how it influences the person you become later in life. The Buddha advises, both in Mangala Sutta and in the Parabhava Sutta, that you should spend time with good friends, family, and those who are genuinely helpful to you. But you must first be considerate of your own time. You must not spend an excessive amount of time. Everything in moderation. You must first attend to your own responsibilities and then to those of your friends and others. If you postpone your responsibilities to do things for others, then you will not succeed. You will see a definite downfall in your own journey. In the fourth stanza of the Parabhava Sutta, the Buddha explains that after you have earned your education, success, money, materialistic belongings, and respect of your peers and society, some people forget their beginning. They forget their parents, their poor relatives, and those who were there for them when there were no friends, success or popularity. With materialistic wealth and popularity, some people tend to be ashamed of their humble beginnings. You have some experience about those people. They don't like to mention the village they come from, and farmers they associate with. Eventually, they convince others that they either came from Cinnamon Gardens or Kandy or Colombo 7, like that way. Some people like to mention their village. Some don't know, even like to mention the country where they were born. Sometimes you met some people like that. They forget those who helped them get there, teachers, parents, neighbors. There is an expression that says, it takes a village to raise a child. I will repeat it. It takes a village to raise a child. Don't forget your village. You know, the once Buddha, when he traveled to Kusinara, finally he turns once to his village. He feel good air, blowing air from his village. He mentioned that. Even Buddha also accepted that. Otherwise, it will lead to your downfall if you forget. Once they have achieved their success, there are some young adults who eat at fancy restaurants, but they don't invite their parents or their relatives. They are now too important. You have to help your relatives. That shows that you have something that is more important than all the money and popularity in the world. It is called humility and humanity. Give back to the community. Help those who need help. Help the poor. Be an advocate for the vulnerable and our environment. Be a caring person. Be a caring person. In the fifth stanza, Buddha explains that line to those who are respectable and are older leads to one's downfall. Lying to anyone is very bad, but especially to those who are in respectful positions, such as monks, parents and teachers, or other senior citizens who are close to you, and to your doctors even, has an effect of bringing very bad negative consequences if you tell lies. In the sixth stanza, the Buddha explained That means conceited leads you to your downfall. Conceited. There is a sense of overconfidence that develops in some individuals when they gain wealth after having humble beginnings. They think that they have made it. They have everything now. They feel superior to others. This leads to one's destruction or downfall in the end. There are other important factors that the Buddha mentions in other stanzas of the Parabhasutta that would lead to one's downfall. Obsessive attraction to males and females, having multiple relationships outside of your marriage life, your marriage. Marrying people who are substantially older than you or younger than you would lead to your downfall. It is not the 2-3 years. Here mentioned huge gap, 10-15 years. Sometimes can be more age gap. There are many societal and psychological reasons why such partnership do not work in the long term. Entering into incompatible marriage. Buddha mentioned this present social some problems in Parabhasutra. You can notice them. Another factor is an obvious one. Everybody knows that. That is drinking heavily. No need to explain again and again. Becoming addicted to alcohol or drugs, young people tend to visit pubs and clubs because they believe the false advertising they see on billboards depicting that drinking culture is actually fun. But it is not. I am not talking about wanting to do something different or wanting a change of scenery. I am talking about excessive behaviors. Then overeating meat and becoming obese and unhealthy would lead you there. You are also misallocating your money by continuously engaging in these. You are going from light to dark territory if you leave this all. There are four ways you could conduct yourself. We can see these four type of people, group of people around us. You could choose to go from light to darkness, darkness to darkness, or darkness to light. Fourth one is light to light. You have a freedom to choose wherever you are. As children and as adults, we should always focus on activities that should bring us to light. If we are in a darker place, seek the light. If we are fortunate to be in a place of light, seek to go to a lighter place, which is what Nibbana is. The Buddha advises us that you should develop healthy self-confidence. Most of us do these negative activities because we are not satisfied with what we have. Some people like to show off. In group settings, they want to show that they have more than others. It's like a competition today. Cars and other personal belongings. When you show off like this, you show others your inner negative self. be honest to accept like those some qualities. It sends a message that you seek others' approval because you are actually a sad person who constantly requires attention. You lack personal satisfaction. You seek constant stimulation but in negative ways. As you continue to mature and grow to be young adults, remember to choose the wiser path. Let's look at the following Dhammapada, which illustrates what is truly valuable in life.
Arogya parama labha santutthi paramam dhanam visvasa paramanati nibbanam paramam sukham.
You know the meaning. You heard this many times, this gatha. Arogya means good health. Santutti means happiness. In this stanza, Buddha advised that the greatest wealth a person has is good health and happiness that comes from doing good things in life. In order to be physically and mentally healthy, you have to avoid bad things. Be honest to yourself. I have mentioned earlier, no drinking, no wine, etc. You only feed your mind and body with healthy and wholesome things. Viswasa is the trust. Don't break the trust people have in you. Earn the trust of others. Be a trustworthy person. Your greatest ally is your own self, having self-confidence, self-esteem. When you lead the life like this, you can be sure that you have chosen the right path. You will lead the successful and happy life. Step by step, we have to train and tame our mind, recognize our mind. The adults will perish before you, but as the future generation, it is up to you to develop these good qualities. Live happily and pass the wisdom of Dhamma. By the power and wisdom of the Buddha, truth of the Dhamma, and blessing of the Sangha, may you all find happiness, success, and wisdom to follow in the right path. Sanya, I want to bless you on your birthday. Today is her birthday. Everybody can say happy birthday to Senya. So on behalf of all of you and Chief Bante, he's also waiting today for you to bless. After this speech, he will give some few words. Actually, he's not well today. He's suffering from fever, pain after the second dose vaccine. He doesn't feel well. However, he is waiting to bless you, Senya. Senya, so first I want to finish my speech with the passing blessing on your birthday. For you, success, happiness and longevity. By participating in Dhamma school and by listening to Dhamma Desana, such as this, you are developing good qualities that will guide you through this journey called life. I wish you courage, strength, and wisdom to always choose the right path, make the right choices, and become a beacon of light. As well, I would like to wish you all children and parents, adults, may you all realize noble path. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Akasatta ca bhummatta divanaga mahiddhika punyantam anumoditva chiram rakkhantu loka sasanam. Akasatta ca bhummatta divanaga mahiddhika punyantam anumoditva chiram rakkhantu desanam. Akasatta ca bhummatta divanaga mahiddhika punyantam anumoditva chiram rakkhantu tam sadati.
Let me offer some words in Sinhala language. After that, I will transfer merits for all departed relatives. Avasarai Gauri Nayak Hamdaran Vahansa Pinutune. I hope to actually Mama Ada Dharma Desanava English Vasavin Kerala. සිංහලින් කියන අවශ්‍ය නැහැ ඔබට නමුත් කෙටි පණිවිඩයක් කිව්වොත් හොඳයි කියලා මට දැනෙනවා ඒක නිසායි මම කියන්නේ පිනතුන් මංගල සූත්‍රය ගැනත් දන්නවා පරාභව සූත්‍රය බණත් මීට කලින් ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් ඇහුවා සිංහලින් ඇහුවා ඒ ධර්මදේශනා දෙකම ඇහුව මතක තියෙනවා නම් එකම පණිවිඩයයි මම මේක අර පුංචි දරුවගේ උපන්දිනය නිසා ළමය අරමුණු කරගෙන බොහෝ දුරට කරුණ කිව්වත් අපි ඔක්කොටම වටිනවා මේ පණිවිඩය. ඇඩල්ට්ස්ල කියලා නැහැ, වැඩිහිටියෝ කියලා නැහැ. මොකද මේ ඉන්න පුංචි කාලය තුර වුණත්, ඉදිරියට ඉන්න කෙටි කාලය තුර වුණත් අපි හරියට අපේ හිත හරි තැන තියාගන්න. හරි මඟ තියලා තියෙනවා. මේක තියෙන ලොකු රහස. වැරදි වෙන්නේ නැති. ඒක පැත්තකට දාන්න. හිතන්නවත් එපා. වෙච්ච දේවල් හිතන්නත් එපා. නොවෙච්ච දේවල් ගැන හිතන්න යන්නත් එපා. අද හරියට හිතාගෙන හරි දේ හරි විදිහට කරගෙන යනවනම් අපේ ජීවිතයේ ඉතිරි කාලේ මේක තියෙන රහස තව ටිකක් ඉගෙන ගන්න මේ රහස මේ හිතේ තියෙනවා අර ඔක්කම් පැත්තක දාන්න කියලා ඒකයි. ඔබ හදාගත්තු ශක්තිය මේක එනර්ජි එකක් බලයක්. හරියට මේක මේ ලයිට් එකක් වගේ. මේක ෆිසිකල් දෙයක් යන්නේ නැහැ මෙතනින් එහාට. හැබැයි අර හිත මූලික කරගත්තු ශක්තිය බලය බොහෝම නිදහස් නිවහල් කාටවත් හිංසාවක් කරදරයක් නැති මනසක් බවට පත් කරගෙන තිබුණොත් ඇත්තටම ඔබ දිනු නිවන් දකින්නකම් ඔබ හොඳ තැනක තියා ගන්න පුළුවන් ඒකයි පරාභව සූත්‍රයේ බුදුහාමුදුරුවෝ පෙන්නන්නේ දස අකුසල් වලින් වැළකීලා මේ දේවල් කරන්න එපා කියලා කියන්නේ බුදුහාමුදුරුවෝ අවුරුදු 2000 ගානකට පෙර කියපු දෙය අදටත් වටිනවා. ඒ වගේම මේක තව ඉදිරි කාලෙටත් ඒ ලෙසම වැදගත් වෙනවා. ඉතින් ඒ නිසා පින්තුනේ අපි හැමෝම කුසල් සිත් පෙරදරි කරගෙන අපේ ගමන අපේ ජීවිතය අපි සකස් කරගන්නවා කියලා ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරගෙන අදිස්ථාන කරගන්නවා. ඉතින් පින්තුන්ට සීම සිද්ධ වෙන්නට මේ ධර්ම දේශනාවේ පින්කම් ඒකාන්ත වශයෙන්ම මෞදේ මෞපිය ඒ වගේම ගුරුවර වැඩිහිටි දූදරු හැම දිනාටම හේතුපත් වේවා ක්‍රම ආශිර්වාද කරමින් නායක හමුරන්ට මම අවස්ථාව දෙනවා සෙන්යාගු උපන්දිනයේට විශ් කිරීම සඳහා
thank you thank you everyone
සෙන්ය
daughter you are very good girl
මේ පැත්තකින් හොඳයි
very smart girl Today your birthday, I bless you, may you find patience, courage, understanding all you do. we will happy and peaceful special day and always. Good health and long life. Thank you.